Oh, welcome to the shop today on what could be the first possible one of these videos. Not sure if this is going to make it out to see the light of day, but I was supposed to be putting this back together and then taking the other side apart and resealing it. They rode the brakes and they got them hot and they burnt some seals out of some things here. So this is the rear axle out of a big wheel loader. So considering that I don't have parts because it's raining and of course airports don't work, so overnight parts don't come, we're going to be heading over to the workbench over here and doing a starter generator. Here we go. For those of you who don't know what this is a starter generator. It's off an older Briggs & Stratton from about, I think it's from the late 60s. I'm not really sure. But I took it apart the other day, ordered some parts. We've got some new brushes here, new bearings and a bushing for it, some springs. And this should be all the parts. Probably lost something. It's been sitting in a box for, I guess, maybe 2 or 3 months now. So I don't know what the heck that is. Okay, we'll figure it out where it goes. Let me finish getting this thing apart. I got inspired to do this because I was watching quite a couple people's videos of them in their own shop. Doing a cool heater just turned off. Just taking stuff apart, talking about it. Talking about life, having a good time. So, why not? I'm by myself in the shop. And what the heck, why not have a good time with it? Try it out, see if I can do it. Because, you know, everything on YouTube looks really easy. So, try it yourself, right? Even though you probably make a big fool of yourself like I'm probably going to do here. All right, I don't know. I guess this is soldered? Oh, great. Okay. Well, that's fun. We get to solder today then. Not quite sure how to get this up out of here. This is just oh, would you look at that? Okay. Get the shitty screwdriver for prying stuff. This is the pry bar screwdriver versus the other one. Those are the good ones. Thou shalt not foul the end of that screwdriver. All right. Yeah. All right. Oh, boy, that looks kind of crummy, doesn't it? Yeah, we'll leave it out for a minute, maybe. Maybe if I feel ambitious, I'll clean them up. We'll see how long this takes. This one out of here. Wow. Springs. Usually springs are a big pain in the ass. I got my weller here, and I got some, check this out, vintage Radio Shack. Well, it's probably not really vintage, but whatever. It's kind of fun, because it's, I don't even know where there's a Radio Shack around here anymore, so definitely have had this for about 10 years. See if we can get this to melt that off of there, and there we go, yeah, all right, nice. Let's see if I can burn myself quite well now. Let's see what we got. Let's see if we can melt this sucker off of there. It's gonna take forever to heat that thing up. So while it's heating, this thing, it's a starter generator. So what it does is it starts and it generates. So it's just it's a DC motor. It's, don't know too much about electric motors. I know enough to be dangerous, that's for sure. But, so it's built a lot heavier than a generator. The windings in it are pretty beefy, as you can see right here. I mean, it's no joke, right? You know, for a generator, if you've ever seen it. What the heck is going on here? What, I've only got these big monkey pliers here now? Let's see what I can break with these. Right. This thing, you apply power to the armature, you ground the field, and it cranks the engine over till it starts. And once it starts, then it switches its function from a starter into a generator, hence the name, and it makes enough current to charge your battery back up and run a few lights. I really don't know how much current they really do make, but they're enough. It's enough to get the job done. Oh boy, I might have to. I don't know if this is going to do it.
That might be crimped on there. That sucking thing.
Yeah, all right, I'm going to try to go get a torch and do this and definitely melt some shit down and have to go buy the whole thing over again. So, all right.
1 minute.
Okay. Got some more tools. So we're going to start crowding the workbench up with more tools here. Fuck this thing. That's how it's coming off. Oh, a little warm.
This thing's filthy as shit. So this, if this takes solder, I'd be pretty amazed, actually.
Get this stretched out. Oh, look at that. Nice assholes in that. Okay. Ooh, it is wetting. Nice. Okay, cool. All right, get that looking like that there. And a little more heat. I'm going to try and stick that on that wire while it's just liquid and see if maybe we can, dare I say, get away with it. Ooh, that felt like that worked really well for how terrible. Fuck, it's burning my fingers. Ow. All right, so let's see. Yeah, I like that. That's on there. Okay, now this one is way the fuck down in here. So, how to get this one off without destroying things? I could take the... No, can't take the field out. You can tell I already screwed that all to hell trying to get that out of there. So, I guess... Never mind that. Oh, can I? It's out of the way. Yeah, this is a recipe for disaster. You know, you set out with the best intentions to do the best job you can. You're like, oh, I'm going to change all these and do that. And start looking at things and you realize that this really isn't that bad. There's really nothing kind of wrong with that almost at all. So, in my unprofessional opinion, it might be best bet to not screw at that. That still has a really nice connection. The stud still looks pretty reasonable. I mean, there's nothing wrong with that. So I'm just going to put that back through with new insulators on it and run it.
That doesn't feel right.
Get out of the shot! You're blocking my view, you fool! There we go. See, that's how that's supposed to fit, but I don't think this side has that. Okay, this side can't handle that. Okay, so where's the one I took out? Ah, it is different. Okay, see here. Okay, figures. All right, I guess back to the old insulator. Let's see, what's this? Wait a minute. There's the right one. Looking at the wrong shit. Here, throw that on the fucking floor. I don't fuck that up again. Oh, look at that. It's a beautiful thing. And it goes together. Okay. All right. So what are we at now? Probably at 10 minutes just to change one, not even two, just one part on this damn thing. Because why would anything ever go right? That's the kind of welcome to the industry here. If you're in repair, you'd know that already. If you're not, welcome to the game. These don't conduct electric at all. So I'm not cleaning them up. They're fine. They'll move. They'll do their job. Let me get some new springs out of the package here. Okay. So let's see. This has got to go. This thing's going to get pushed in. So this has got to go. This is going to hook behind that. So this is going to go like all the way around. To like here, okay. I think I can. We'll find out. Get this out of the way, and let's see how many times I gotta curse everything to get this back together. Here's. I said, oh, that spring was easy before. Now watch this thing get really fun. Let's see. Come on. It's fucking. What the. Oh, come on. I did the same thing again. Oh. Did I just spring? Ah! There we go. Oh. And, of course, the bottom has hooked its own hole. Why is this being so finicky today? I can't do anything when I'm being watched and I should know better. And this is the kind of the proof in the pudding. Like, try and do something when you're watched, and of course that's when nothing works out at all. Okay. So I take back what I said before. Springs are always a pain in the ass when you gotta tension them, like without a bolt or without some kind of draw feature on the thing. You're just trying to like fight it around like this. And it shoots out. Whoa, that is on the edge. There we go. Ah, look at that. Okay. Let's put a brush in here. So like this here. Put that. Oh, look at. Wow, that's cool. All right. I guess that, yeah, that is the brush holder. That is how that sits. Okay. Get the proper screwdriver now. So put this back in. This just grounds. This goes to the case. So this just completes the electrical circuit on this thing. Because the case is the ground in most automotive systems, and that is where the designs for this has come from. Come on. Whoops. Fuck. Alright, fuck these things. These things suck. That's the end of that. Fuck them. Can't do any fucking fine work with those things on. Now I lost the fucking screw. There it is. Okay. Let's try this. This way. Seems kind of fiddly. There we are. Okay. All right. Cool. All right. This goes in there. Goes like that. Wow, look at that. Okay, cool. All right, now if I can just annoy myself with the other side, but I'm not going to annoy you with that. All right. So this is that thing I didn't know what the hell it did before. Does this fit in? It doesn't fit there, obviously. Kind of fit. Let's see. Here's the retainer. This has a felt in it here. So there's felt in there, and this kind of. Oh, I know what this is. This is the old shielding for the old bearing. Let's see. This should kind of just go right in here. I'm going to tap this down around the outside. You want to try to not strike the inner race on any bearing. So you wouldn't hit it here, because then you put the load that you're driving it with through the bearing. This is going to tap right in. This thing is not any kind of a press fit at all. So I'm just going to work my way around the outside here. And one missed shot on this and you blow that seal up, then you don't have a sealed bearing anymore. And so, don't get too nuts. There we go. That's the sound of being done. So, that's in. And we'll thread this son of a bitch back together. And then our front cover is in pretty good shape. The back cover now, this has a bushing in there. So I already had this apart and I already put it back together before I found out that the front bearing was gone. So I ordered the kit and it came with the back bearing. This back bearing is still very tight. This thing does not have a lot of hours on it. It's pretty old, but it has very low hours. So this behind here is a piece of felt or some kind of material. In this chamber here, and then very difficult to see. This is very dark in there. Try and get. I had a pick here somewhere. There we go. If I go in here with the pick, there's a hole in it. See, I can go right through it. This felt continues up. There's a drilling here. This drilling goes down in. There's the felt chamber. Here's the back of our bushing, and this comes through and there's a little cut in there, so that way this oil wicks up that felt, and then it, when it spins in there, it carries it around a little bit. So that's a primitive way for a friction bearing to be oiled. Works pretty good. I mean, normally you'd have an oil cup on here. I don't quite understand. This is. Is this? Yeah, that's capped off. Sometimes they put the, you know, little flappy things with the door on them on the top. Those little oilers. Those are. I like those. Maybe one day down the road I get that out and put one of them in there if this thing gets dry. But for now, let me get the extra fucking schmutz off of this thing, too, so that way we don't end up spitting it out all over the brushes that are back here. So that's extra. Pick up our armature. My buddy, who works in a motor shop, as I don't know what the heck he does there, but he works in a place that does motors. So. I don't know what the heck I'm doing with this stuff. So he come over and we've tested this all out and everything's good and cleaned it all up. And there's supposed to be some kind of coating that we can spray on here. There's a number, 800-212. Free call to Manhattan, I suppose. This is supposed to have some kind of rust protectant on or something. I don't really have anything that's like this varnishy stuff. So I don't really know what to do with that. It's not what I could do with it. It's what I can do with it with the stuff that I have here. That's more the problem. If anybody can go, my grandfather likes to say, well, anybody can go to the store and buy a truckload of lumber and put a building together. But it takes, I don't know, I guess it takes somebody who knows what they're doing, I suppose, to put a building together with all the cutoffs and junk and bent wood and all the crap that they can't sell. And remember, he used to be on the roof of buildings putting rafters up. Maybe all twisted. So if you bolt and stuff together, come along and it's straight. All kinds of ridiculous stuff. I guess he liked the fight. So there's a car coming up. So I'm going to kill this for a second here. Okay, the guest has left the shop and we are getting back to work here. So I was talking with him. I slid this back through. I had to pull the brushes in to get this in. Nothing difficult there, nothing even worth showing. Probably half of this really actually isn't worth even showing, really, but whatever, we'll see. We'll see to see if it ever makes it to YouTube channel. Now, this goes on, there's a little indexing pin on here. So I'm going to get this on here and get that indexing pin setting in there. And now... Okay, I'll stand this up on its end, and here we go. Now, this, I didn't know what to do with the coating on the armature, so I did nothing. All right, so that's not right, but, okay, this end has threads in it, so that is not the pivoting end, so this has to go this way. So, now, this shoulder here, right there, sits right at just slightly higher than the surface of this. So this we gotta find probably the fat one. I'm gonna say, let's see, maybe both. Is that possible? Is that right? We're gonna put both in here. No, that's not right because this shoulder sits into that. So let's see what one gets us. So. Tip this back up. I'll drop this on here first. Put that on there. There's an indexing pin on this here as well. So I'll put this on there. Oh, come on. Where is the hole? That's what she said. Okay. There's our end play now. I think that's probably about right for these things. So then this must go on this side of it. Nice. Okay. We got to put a keyway into this thing. So there's a keyway that's got to go in. Hold on here. Is this thing fucking up? There we go. All right, I gotta find a washer for that. Now that, oh, that is it. Okay. Look, this corrosion on here, when I looked at it, made it in kind of an obstacle delusion that I thought it was this, because it looked like out of round, and this is actually the gasket off the float bowl on this, the fucking thing that hangs underneath the gas tank. Sediment bowl, there we go, sediment bowl. Okay. Something sounds a little... It feels fine. I get a little, kind of a little in there. A little, who are you? Get this off. I guess it's just the brush is kind of doing what brushes do on the commutator. So, all right. We'll strap this back into it now. Put that on there. Drop these things on here. Now I'm putting this together. Whoop. There we go. Just loosely so I can test this thing out. So let me go get. Let me see if I can. I guess I got to tighten. Turn these down. All right, now, this thing is pretty, these are pretty dense, these things. These are not, this end cap is aluminum, but everything else in this is steel or cast iron, or it's not, nothing about it made it to be light. That bushing in the back is definitely cheaper than the one in the Cub Cadets. The one in the Cub Cadets come with, they had two bearings. They had a bearing in both ends, but... And of course, I left out the most important thing in there, the copper windings. Whoa. But yeah, it's all steel. Yeah, dummy. This is the original one. I don't know where the front housing went to, because this engine that this is going on, I brought it over to my buddy's place. Left it with him for a couple of years. It was seized up, left it with him. He disassembled it to find out what was so wrong about it, and found out what was wrong with it and left it apart. The ring stuck to the board, shattered, all kinds of other great things. And so here we are years and years later. I rebuilt the engine and I'm trying to keep as much of the original equipment on it as I can, but the front to this is long lost. That's gone. I got it back from him in one piece. This, as you see it now, but this was taken for parts quite some years ago. The brushes were stolen out of it. Like I said, it was a low hour unit. So he, when you're a farmer and you need something and you got something else that will fit in its place that has less hours on it, you just do it every farmer. Switch the shit over, you know? Okay. All right. Go get a battery and some cables. Okay. Get this battery. There we go. Alright, good crapper pillar battery here. Nice good takeout. And yeah. Alright. Let's get some. And okay. This is the problem with making your own jumper cables. Okay. These things are as stiff as a board. And that's because they're homemade from big, heavy, fat house wire, which does a great job at staying in your walls and not moving around in there. Does a really terrible job of trying to flex it to get it to behave properly when you're trying to persuade it to do things like this. Now, if I remember correctly, I'll put this on the armature. I'll put a nut on here so I don't completely fuck these threads all up with stupidity. And maybe let me switch these. So this. All right, that goes on there. Now, I think I got to get a jumper for the ground. The field. Because the field's got to be grounded, as far as I know, to make this run. So everything's further away from the camera than its field of vision. So, and, I only work in here if I'm lucky, one day a week. So, of course, you never know where anything is. Yeah, let's try it. What's the worst thing that happens? If the fuel gets energized, doesn't run. Let's see. Let's see. Whoa, there we go. Oh, it'll work without the field. Okay. Let's see what we got. Nice. All right. So, good enough for government work. Get all this shit out of here. That runs. Time to tighten it down and, you know, install it, I guess. So, all right. Talk to you later. Thanks for watching.